Hi, it's Dwyer. RichardDwyer.com, keepingitfree.blogspot.com. I'm a lawyer in Northern California. I also run gamblersadvisory.com, a sports site. And from time to time, I'll comment on criminal cases that are in the news. Now, I made a video a few months ago on the Amanda Knox case, and that video surprisingly got over 2,000 views. Right, that video has been a lightning rod for many people who have left comments on the case. Let me make a couple of points. This is a case that has raised emotions in a lot of people. And what I have noticed is that whenever you talk about the Amanda Knox case, someone will respond here online and we'll start blurring people. We'll start blurring facts. Right? There seems to be a group out there, in my opinion, and I'm just giving you my opinion, that seems to have an interest in confusing the clear facts of the case, in confusing the evidence. Right? Let's be very clear here. There is no question, none whatsoever, that Amanda Knox knowingly and falsely accused her boss, Patrick Lumumba, of this murder. Right? There's none. She actually gave a written statement to the authorities. Right? Lumumba clearly had nothing to do with this crime. He has an airtight alibi. He was with someone else in a different location. He wasn't even at the murder scene. Now, what I want people to do is I want people to read through the comments to my earlier video on Amanda Knox. Those comments are mind-blowing, right? In addition to a lot of great comments from people who are raising factual arguments, you have other comments where people are trying to blur individuals. They're trying to mix Patrick Lumumba, a black man who was not at the murder scene, right, with Rudy Gaudet, a black man who is convicted of this crime, as is Amanda Knox, right, who is convicted of this crime, who left DNA at the murder scene, right? In my opinion, this factual distortion is intentional. Right, I believe there are people out there who, in their effort to throw sand on obviously incriminating evidence, will distort the evidence. Right, so what I want people to do is to read the comments to my earlier video and ask yourself if the inaccuracies contained in some of those comments, literally, one poster repeatedly, in post after post, is spinning the facts, is making inaccurate statements, and then is contentiously accusing others of being dumb, not knowing the facts, being stupid, etc. Right? Just ask yourself whether or not you feel that that's part of some conscious effort to hide the truth in the Amanda Knox case. Right? Let me also make a recommendation. There's an excellent article on the evidence in the case, right? The website is the Independent website. It's www.independent.co.uk. The author is Layla Schneps. The date of the article is February the 2nd, 2014. Again, that's February the 2nd, 2014. The headline, the title of the article is "It's Not Right to Say There Is No Evidence in the Case Against Amanda Knox." There's plenty. Right again, the headline, the title is "It's Not Right to Say There Is No Evidence in the Case Against Amanda Knox." There's plenty. Right? The piece skillfully talks about specific pieces of evidence. The bra claps. Right? The mixed stain. Understand, there is DNA right, from the room of the flatmate that has mixed blood from Amanda Knox and the victim, Meredith Kircher. Right? Understand that Luminol was able to reveal that blood stain. Right? Understand, too, that there is a knife that was seized from the apartment of Amanda Knox's boyfriend. Right? I would encourage you to look at the DNA test results from that knife. So, to sum up, don't believe the misinformation. What I want you to rely on is your own independent investigation of this case. I would argue that the physical evidence, as well as the false accusation of murder made by Amanda Knox against a man she knew was innocent, her boss, Patrick Lumumba, shows a consciousness of guilt. In fact, in my opinion, it shows the reality of guilt. Right? So just research the case, but as you do so, just consider the fact that Meredith Kircher was supposed to be Amanda Knox's roommate, but yet Amanda Knox, at one point here, tried to divert the police away from the real culprits and toward her boss. That's the personality type we're dealing with. Don't fall for people who will then try to say, hey, you know, the boss was at the murder scene and left DNA. Right? That's just a factually false statement. What's even worse are the follow-up statements where they then try to convince you, while making misrepresentations about the case, that only they know about the case and that you don't know about the case, and that Italy, right, a country with a long history, has an axe to grind with sexually active young women, right, and that Italy doesn't know how to read a DNA test, and that Italian authorities may have planted evidence, right? There's simply no evidence of that. So let's talk about the Amanda Knox case. I'd like to hear your comments, but let's both have knowledge of the fact that whatever is written here, either by me or by you, is going to ultimately be distorted by folks with a different agenda. Let's keep our eye on the actual facts of the case, and let's not fall prey to people who want you to ignore the DNA evidence, right? Ignore the false accusation made against an innocent man, right? Ignore the physical evidence, things like the bra clasps. Let me hear from you. Thanks for stopping by. I hope you give that article at independent.co.uk a look. It's a good read. Thanks for stopping by.